It's been over a year since I got LG's OLED TV for long-term testing. Like many, I was also interested to find out how reliable OLED technology is, not for usual review period, but for typical day-to-day usage. The fact that LG has decided to supply me with its very first model for marathon testing says much about their confidence about this new exciting display technology. This is the second video report I am making, so for more details check description below. Here I will just say that I'm using TV every day to watch standard and high definition content. I watch YouTube a lot, but also Netflix and content on Blu-ray. Often I use TV's built-in media player for music listening and also several news apps that have static interface. Using service remote control, I checked how many hours TV worked until now. 2691 hours or 112 days. TV was updated several times between January 2015 and today with official software updates. Okay, so as in previous verification, I used Spectracle's C6 meter and Kelman software together with VideoForge HDMI pattern generator to measure again calibrated Expert 1 preset. Let's see how measurements look like and how they compare with previous results. As you can see, measured values did not change much, with gamma, color gamut and gamut luminance remaining almost the same. Surprisingly, peak brightness returned almost to the same value as in January 2015, when TV was calibrated. When I did the measurement in October, brightness fell 5% and now we talk only about 0.5% reduction. I will share why I think this is happening a little bit later. But so far I'm glad to see that TV still has same bright picture as before. On the other side, white balance is no longer ideally balanced as it was after calibration. In October I saw slight decrease of blue, but this was not something you can notice when watching content. I expected that blue would continue to decrease since many were mentioning issues with blue OLED material. But here comes another surprise. Blue is no longer decreasing, but actually it is red component that lowered its presence and blue got back to where it was. Green component increased the most on all levels, which is not good because our eyes will notice it more easily than other colors. That is why calibrators pay special attention to green during white balance adjustment. Because white balance results were not following those from October, I repeated in next few days two more measurements of Expert 1 preset. Still, results were the same. Then I took other picture presets which were not touched so far and measured them as well. Good thing I had their results from January 2015. Okay, let's see what is going on. Standard preset is poorly set by default in terms of white balance, but still it is clear that green component increased, while red slightly fell. Blue stayed almost the same. Peak brightness slightly increased. I discovered the same in Expert 2 preset. THX Cinema, which is completely locked for any adjustments in user menus, showed same trend, increase of green and decrease of red. Blue component fell a little bit, but not as much as back in October. Here I also measured slightly increased peak brightness. It is hard to say what is causing changes in white balance and in peak brightness. I know that LG is testing OLED panels 24/7 and collecting a large amount of data to better understand what is going on with these screens over time. I guess they can then use that information to release new software update, which will readjust white balance or other aspects of the picture to keep it balanced. Perhaps software update is not even needed. OLED TVs may already have some sort of compensation algorithms that do these things after a certain number of hours. Regardless of that, I can say that for me, LG's OLED TV is working perfectly and that I'm enjoying movies with the same excitement as when I started this test. Colors are punchy and beautifully rendered, upscaling is high quality and motion is not perfect but acceptable for movies and sports. Dirty screen effect is very light and it does not bother me while I watch sports or play games. Near black uniformity is not great, but this occurs so rarely during content watching that I do not consider it as a big minus. With that being said, I can still highly recommend LG's OLED TVs. In terms of pure picture quality, There are no better alternatives on the market right now, and it seems that this won't change in coming years. I will keep testing my samples, so be sure to come back to my channel for third report after TV passes 5000 working hours. I would like to use this opportunity to thank to LG Electronics office in Croatia for their excellent support and a chance to test this wonderful piece of technology.